Let's take a look at the Qlik Insight Bot changes for June 2020. The first major change that we're introducing for Qlik Insight Bot is the introduction of the single installer. With the June release, the installer is now performed with some pre-installation and post-installation configuration steps required, but all of the 9 installations are now consolidated into one single installer. Upgrades will require a partial uninstall and then reinstall, but importantly all of your configuration and bindings are preserved. So once you've uninstalled, you can just reinstall using the new installer and you will get back up and running. Now within the installer there are optional components for the NLU and the channels integration. This allows you to have split server installations so you can run the installer and install the relevant components on the necessary servers. The next capability that we're introducing is the third-party API. This is an optional install and it's compatible with Qlik Insight Bot February 2020 and June 2020. This enables integration with third-party platforms. So whilst we provide out-the-box integration with Teams and Slack, this allows you to introduce custom channels yourself using the API if you want to build them. And also, which is one of the most common requests, is an integration point into other corporate chat platforms. So if you have a platform that is handling day-to-day operational questions about your business, you can now introduce Insight Bot to be able to offload questions to Qlik of an analytical nature. Now, the API is available on a closed access basis for delivery through consulting services. So it won't be available to download on the download site, but it will be accessible directly from Qlik when delivered through a consulting services engagement. The demo that I want to show today is the use of the third-party API. In this particular case, we have an endpoint that we can request to. We provide the user ID in the user directory and the message that that we're sending, which is the question. We can also specify the email address in a similar way as we do for example, Teams and Slack access. Now, importantly, we are assuming that the service that is making the request is authorized to act on behalf of that user. So this is very similar to header authentication that's possible within Qlik Sense. Therefore, making requests directly from the user's browser isn't a suitable solution, but it should be made by a back-end service which is acting on behalf of the third-party software that's being used. So here the request has been made, and the response has been structured into the output text, the image attachment, and the associated text that goes with that image. Also, additionally, any buttons and follow-up content will be provided, which then can be styled and visualized as you see fit. Now, it's great looking at an API like we've just seen, but we can bring this to life and show an example of how you could integrate this. Now, in this particular example, I have built a web app that is integrated with the API in question, and I'm able to ask questions about my sales, for example, and get those responses back and visualized in a way that seems familiar to users of Insight Bot. But importantly here, I have full control over the styling and the structure of this particular output. Also the buttons and questions that that I can then use to follow on. But as with all APIs, you're really only limited by your imagination and the use case that you have. And so something that we don't see as broadly available is the text only. And so if we ask, for example, sales for 2017, I can ask that question, but I also have the full breadth of APIs available from the browser, from other services, to do something a little bit more clever with it.
Sales for 2017.
Sales is $507,540 for 2017.
Use dictation to interpret these and create really interesting applications using the API given their particular use cases. So this is just an example of how you can use the API to both build in a more traditional experience, but also something which is a little bit more interesting in terms of use cases, particularly for things like voice assistants, etc. And so this API unlocks these capabilities for customers who want to look beyond the current integrations that are possible. And finally, we're introducing some improvements to bookmarks and selections. Bookmark handling has been improved, and this allows us to manage bookmarks with increased number of selections within them. Now, across the board, and it's particularly relevant for bookmarks, we're now displaying selections as one bubble per field. And if you have a single value, it will specify the value you've selected, but as soon as you have multiple values, whereas before we would introduce multiple bubbles per value, we're now listing the count per field. This reduces the amount of space taken up by the selections in your question responses and gives you a much cleaner way of asking the questions and getting the result.